Well, today I'm down at Bendora Dam in the ACT with a group of fishery scientists who are looking to find ways to re-establish a sustainable population of one great Aussie freshwater fish, the trout cod.
These beautiful fish are a nationally endangered species, with only three natural populations left in Australia. Over the last 20 years, scientists have restocked our rivers with 1.5 million trout cod fingerlings. The trouble is, many of them just didn't survive. Since then, they've tried raising hatchery fish to adult size, but they still can't hack it when they meet predators in the real world.
We attributed this to these being quite naive fish, so they were brought up in a hatchery, fed a fairly basic diet, and then released into the wild.
So the fisheries team here in the ACT is monitoring the local trout cod populations to work out ways of improving their odds. These spike nets are set up around Bendora Dam, so Jason and his crew can check the age and size of the trout cod in the system.
Oh, there we go. So we've got a few fish in there.
Looks like we've got three or four two-spine blackfish.
Two-spine blackfish? Well, I've never seen one of these before.
No trout cod today, but another bottom dweller. The two-spine blackfish, also a threatened species in these parts.
They almost look like a bit of a cod.
Yeah.
Researchers are also using technology to track down the trout cod.
10 metres off there. 151.56.
We put tags in fish that either emit a radio signal or an acoustic signal, and with that tracking you can determine what habitat the fish is using, so whether they're aggregating around logs or rock piles or things like that. We can also tell what depth the fish are at. So then if we want to place artificial spawning habitats in the dam, we know what positions and at what depth to place them at.
Trout cod spawn in hollow logs or drums. So the scientists are planning to put spawning drums in the dam to give the fish more places to breed. And they have one more trick up their sleeve. Before they release more hatchery fish into the wild, they're sending them to fish school.
And basically that's using predators, be they fish or cormorants, to scare the living daylights out of little fellas so that they learn not to get gobbled by them.
Their ultimate goal is to help the trout cod breed in the wild for generations to come. To learn more about this great work, go to the Fisheries Research and Development Corporation website.